Student Brightspace Orientation. Welcome. This course will help you get acquainted with Brightspace and many of its features. You also have opportunities to practice some Brightspace activities so you become more familiar with the process. So, learning objectives. After completing this course, students will be able to personalize course settings and notifications, navigate Brightspace to desired locations, submit assignments, complete quizzes in Brightspace and quizzes that use respondents, participate in Brightspace discussions, access grades and various types of instructor feedback, and find additional resources for support. So this is the student Brightspace orientation video.
Welcome to the UMA Student Brightspace Orientation course. We've developed this course to help all UMA learners better understand how to navigate in the Brightspace Learning Management System. This video is designed to give you just a brief overview of what appears in this course. As you work through the course modules yourself, you will find more in-depth information about how to navigate and use Brightspace. The page we're looking at right now is the home page of a course, and when you open UMA courses, you will always open to the course home page. To get to the information that you want to work with in the course, you can utilize the course nav bar, which is this blue bar across the top, and you can also use the course modules widget on the right side of the screen. Accessing a module from this page here will bring you to the same place that you can access through the content. We do encourage that students utilize the content tab rather than the course module widget because you have more information at a glance here. And sometimes when you open the module widget, it's easy to overlook submodules that are inside that module. So let's go ahead and move on to our content page. In any UMA course, the first time you open the content page, it will bring you to the syllabus tab. This is a great place to find information from your faculty member. They might introduce themselves. They might include a copy of the syllabus. We have included a sample syllabus. Please note, this is not specific to this course. It is just an example of what a UMA syllabus might look like. As we continue on, you'll notice that in your table of contents, there is a list of modules. Each module is organized by name and topic. So in this course, we're going to cover aspects of navigating in Brightspace, personalizing it to meet your learning needs. You'll understand how to work with the assignments tool, the quizzes and test tool, the discussion tool. You'll also get a sense for how to find your grades, which can be found in multiple ways in Brightspace, how to find feedback from your faculty, and how to track your own course progress. We've also provided a series of supports around using Zoom and Kaltura because these are tools that are free for use for all UMA students and do frequently get used in UMA courses. Some students find using the Brightspace app, which is called Pulse, a valuable tool, so we have provided some support around that. In our bonus support resources, you will find information about the UMA libraries and the writing centers and the Student Tech Hub and other supports to help you with your academic venture at UMA. The Student Brightspace Orientation course is designed to support you in the ways that work best for you. If you're new to Brightspace, you might decide to take this course in full so that you get a complete picture of how Brightspace and other learning tools at UMA work. You also might decide to come back to this time and time again as you have questions that arise in navigating Brightspace. We hope this course supports you well in your academic journey and have a good semester.
So this is the Student Tech Hub. This is Connect, Collaborate, and Learn. So fall classes begin 8/30/2021 in Brightspace. I've actually started this on 8/29. Brightspace courses may open before the 30th to help you plan for a good start. So what do you want to learn today? We've got Wi-Fi, devices, Brightspace, workspace. They talk about Main Street, Kaltura, Zoom, and the bookstore to help. So, let's see about Brightspace. That happens when we click on that. So we've got the orientation, the video tutorials that we've already seen, Pulse, which is the Brightspace app. So if you have any questions, basically the Student Tech Hub will be a good place to go. So let's see, we viewed this. Now we've started, we can go over the course homepage and layout.
The course homepage in Brightspace should be fairly consistent regardless of the class that you're in. Note, though, there may be some differences depending on how the instructor has laid out their specific course. In the upper left, we have the home button, which will bring us back to the highest level, showing us all of our courses that we are able to go to in Brightspace. We see that we are in the UMA Brightspace. This will also bring you back to a higher level of view, showing you all of the courses that you have. We can see that we are in our sample course. If you go to the right, we have the toolbar that has our manage alerts, any messages, and any notifications that we have. We'll also see our name in the upper right, and if we've uploaded a profile picture. Clicking this will allow us to go into our profile settings, notifications, and account settings, which we've covered in a different video. We have the boxes here that if you select, will show you all the courses that you have that you're able to select and go into. What we have below that is called the navigation bar. There are multiple things we can do in the navigation bar. Course Home will bring us back to the page that we are on right now. Content will bring us to the table of content outline in our course. Course Resources has a number of resources for you, email, your calendar, the announcements. Assessments hold most of the content that is in the course that you are taking, grades, assignments, discussions, and more. And Tools and Help. Tools show the Zoom meetings that are in the course that you're in, along with your media that you've posted on your Kaltura Media, and any course media that's been loaded by the instructor. Let's go and look at content. The top three won't change, no matter what class you're in. You have your syllabus, which should hold the syllabus to your course, along with some other course information. Bookmarks, which will hold bookmarks that you've set throughout the course for material that you'd like to revisit, or that you haven't yet taken a look at, and you'd like to remember to do that. Your course schedule will show you any due dates or any dates coming up in your course. Underneath that, the table of content outlines the content in your course. This may change depending on the course. It may be by weeks, by modules, or other options that the instructor may have chosen. If we click into one of our weekly modules, we'll see the outline of the module be fairly consistent as well. We have content. And underneath each piece, it will tell you what the content is. See, we have a PowerPoint, an assignment, and a discussion topic in the Week 1 module. And that is the basic overview of the Brightspace layout for your course.
So, the visual table of contents. The visual table of contents, or TOC, allows not only an outline of the course content that has been released, but it also gives you a variety of ways to interact with course information. Before diving right in, let's look at the different ways we can use this tool. So we have the before we start, and we have the one, which is the module info. You see this icon, you can click on it to flip the module cards and view module specific information and outcomes if your facility is using this feature. Two, resume arrows, which are in the corner. Clicking the double arrows on the right of model of the card will take you to where you left off in the content. Three, model image. Clicking anywhere in the model image will take you to the top of the content table of contents. Four is the model name, module name, and title. Clicking on the module title will take you to the top of that module's content. Five is the progress bar. Viewing the progress bar lets you quickly assess how much of the required content and activities you will have completed for each module. However, it's a best practice to double-check your syllabus and course calendar to make sure you've met all module goals. So course navigation. So this one has two different videos and some stuff to navigate. So we'll start with this one.
In this video, we will cover the basics of navigation within the Brightspace courses. And now I am logging in into a typical Brightspace course. The first thing you want to do is to adjust notification settings for your account to find the right balance of notifications you will receive for activities in your courses. You can choose the ways you want to receive notifications: by text to your cell phone or by email. It is a very individual setting. Too many or too little notifications could be detrimental to your involvement in the courses you are taking. Again, the right balance is the key for your success. And once you are done adjusting notifications, please don't forget to hit the save button. Now we are back in the course. We will look at the buttons like update alerts, subscription alerts, and message alerts. And of course, we will check the waffle menu. This area is called mini bar. The waffle menu allows you to jump from one course to another really quickly. A mini bar is always with you in any part of the course or in any course while you are in Brightspace. The messages button allows you to send instant messages or emails to your classmates. Once you click the address book, you will see the list of the classmates. You can choose one or all of the participants in your course, add recipients, and send your message. And the last button in the mini bar is called update alerts. Once you click here, you will see all the messages, update messages that you have received through Brightspace. Assignments due, or quizzes ending soon, you name it. And now we got done with our mini bar, and we will move to another bar called Nav Bar or Navigation Bar. And the most interesting tabs for us here are Course Home and Content. Let's take a look at them first. Course homepage is the first page you see when you click into the course. We see the announcements here that you can dismiss once you read them, and you can always revisit your announcements through the course resources and announcements. Another thing that you see here is the course calendar with upcoming events. This is not a full calendar, and the full calendar is also available through course resources calendar. Consider it as a dashboard to your course. On the right, you can see course modules. That gives you direct access to your modules. If I click on lesson 2, for example, I will see the whole lesson 2. And if I click on the play button in lesson 2, I will go to the last visited page in lesson 2. That's important. If your instructor added a description to the module, you will see this information button. Once you click here, you can read the information about the module. And at the bottom of each module that has more than one topic, you will see a personal progress bar. For instance, in Lesson 2, I have visited only 50% of links. I clicked on 50% of all the course materials or topics offered in this module. And in Lesson 1, I was not a very good student, and I have visited only 30% of those. Here on the homepage, you will also see a widget about your instructor, and you can access your Google Drive and other Google apps. Let's return to our navbar. We have already covered Course Home, which is our course dashboard with widgets, announcements, course calendar, course modules, and about the instructor. But now we will talk briefly about course content. Why briefly? Because it is the most important part of your course, and we will cover content tab in a separate video. I will just mention that all your course activities will be happening here in content. On the left, you will see the navigation through your course modules, and in the main area of the page, you will see all the topics posted to you by the instructor. And now we'll mention only the most notable parts of the navbar menu. In the course resources tab, you will be frequently using announcements, calendar, class list, and email tool. Under assessments, you can gain access to all your assignments in the course available to you in assignments. You can see all discussions in the discussions area under assessments, exams and quizzes, and of course, grades. Under tools, some instructors will add videos into course media gallery, but not necessarily so. Many of them you will find in the course content area. My Media gives you access to all your videos in Kaltura media storage, and Zoom is self-explanatory. Under Help tab, you will find UMA Student Tech Hub that provides students with tech support, IT tech support, my UMA portal, and other notable areas that will help you navigate through the course. This video is the second part of the navigation basics within the Brightspace course. We will point to multiple ways to operate in content, as this can be disorienting until you are familiar with it. It's easy to get lost when you aren't paying attention. Let's go. Let's start with the most straightforward way for students to navigate in the Brightspace course. Content tab should be the best friend for you to navigate through the course content. We can see that we are in Lesson 1 here because it is displayed here on top of the module, and we can see on the left navigation that this Lesson 1 module has two submodules or subfolders called Lectures and Films. When we are in Lesson 1 module, we can see the materials included in Lesson 1, as well as all submodules or subfolders called Lectures with content in it, and films. If I click on lectures, I can see only lectures here, and Brightspace tells me that I'm in lecture submodule. So you can easily navigate from module to submodule or another module. And your navigation should be happening here. This is the place where you take assignments, take quizzes, you participate in discussions, and watch the videos. That's where the instructor will put all the course materials in the Brightspace course. On the course homepage, you can see Course Modules widget, where you can go directly to any module in the course. In this case, Lesson 1, Lesson 2, or Lesson 3. Sounds easy? Not so much. Let's take a look. If you click on the image in the module or Lesson 1, you will go to Lesson 1. Now we'll go back. If you click on the Play button, it will take you to the last place you visited in this module. You will not see the whole module. Now let's click on the Content tab. On the left side of the screen, we can see the navigational menu. We can see that we have Lesson 1, Lesson 2, Lesson 3, and when clicking on Lesson 1, we can see that it has two submodules, Lectures and Films. Let's go to Films. One of the navigational obstacles that UMA students encounter is that when they click Course Home and then Content again, it will take you only to the last submodule you visited. Your content navigation needs to happen here on the left navigation.
All right. So then we have some more things down here. So you have the title of where things are, pretty much everything that the videos explained. I think that's it for this video. I'm gonna do a second part. Thanks for listening.